Substance which have a negligibly small free electrons are called non-conductors or insulators. In an insulator like glass, rubber, etc., each electron is attached or bound to a particular atom, and hence these electrons are not free to move in a body of the material. Insulators are also called dielectrics. In chemistry, we studied about two types of molecules. One is polar molecules, another group is non-polar molecules. What is polarization? Is that term familiar to you? Because actually polarization, you will study polarization in optics, that is different, entirely different. And this is polarization in electrostatics. Because maybe you studied some of the molecules like water, ammonia, carbon dioxide, hydrochloric acid or hydrogen chloride, methanol, etc., they behave like electric dipole. And the molecules like hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, etc., they are not behaving as electric dipole. You are familiar with the term electric dipole. What is the meaning of electric dipole? Minus Q and plus Q located at two different points will constitute an electric dipole. You consider an atom. Suppose you consider this 2Hg4. Helium atom. Inside the nucleus, it is very clear that there are two protons. Suppose the protons are, these are the two protons. So the center of mass of the positive charge is exactly at the midpoint of AB. If A and B are the two protons, then exactly at the midpoint, center of mass of the positive charge is there. You know there are two electron sources. These electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Suppose an electron is located here and the second electron is diametrically opposite point. So distance of this electron from this plus charge towards both of these electrons, that is same. Or the center of mass of the negative charge, that is also coincide at the same point. So positive mass, positive charge and negative charge, their center of mass coincides. Is it a dipole? Plus Q and minus Q located at the same point. Is it a dipole? That is not a dipole. So this atom, is it a dipole behaving like a dipole? No, it is not behaving like a dipole. But you assume both these electrons are somewhere here. Assume like that. In that case, you can see very clearly that it is not symmetric with respect to this plus. Therefore, the center of mass of the minus charge is somewhere here. You know, the center of mass here is minus 2e. Total negative charge is minus 2e and total positive charge is plus 2e. Plus Q and minus Q located at two different points. So, in this type of molecules or atoms, they behave like electric dipoles and they are called polar molecules. So, this type of molecules, their center of mass of the positive charge and center of mass of the negative charge are at different points. Therefore, they are behaving like polar molecules. But this type of molecules, their center of mass of positive charge and center of mass of the negative charge are coinciding. So therefore, they are non-polar molecules. Suppose there is a polar molecule. This is a polar molecule. You are keeping this one in an electric field. Keeping the polar molecule in an electric field, then what will happen? It's very clear, there will be induction. So, near to the positive charge, negative charge gets accumulated, and on opposite side, positive charge gets accumulated. Otherwise, the center of mass of the negative charge shifts towards left side, and center of mass of the positive charge gets shifted towards right side. So, the molecular atom which was non-polar earlier, that is converted to a polar molecule now. So, the summary is this one. If a polar molecule is located in an electric field, what will happen? It will become non-polar. Sorry. If a non-polar molecule is located in an electric field, then
the center of mass of positive charge and center of mass of negative charge gets separated, or the same molecules gets converted to an electric dipole, or it behaves like a polar molecule. Non-polar molecule gets converted to polar molecule when, what is the condition? If it is located in an electric field. So the center of mass of positive charge and negative charge gets separated. There is stretching of the atom or stretching of the molecule. Earlier it is symmetric. Center of mass of positive charge and center of mass of negative charge are coincide. If the same material, same atom, same molecule located in an electric field, the center of mass of positive charge and center of mass of negative charge gets separated, and it results to stretching of the atom or molecule, and it will be converted to polar molecule, and this process is called polarization in electrostatics. Now, your dielectric slab. This is a dielectric slab that is located between the positive plate and negative plate of a capacitor. What is the speciality of the electric field between the plates of a capacitor? You know, there is uniform electric field. How much? Sigma by epsilon naught. What is the direction of that electric field? It is from positive charge to negative. Non-zero uniform electric field, sigma by epsilon naught, is existing between the plates of a charged capacitor, and the direction of that electric field is from positive plate to negative plate. That is what you studied in the previous class. In this situation, you are introducing a dielectric slab of thickness T. T is the thickness of the slab, and D is the separation between the plates of the capacitor. So which is greater? Definitely D is greater, T is more. Then only you can insert this slab. Now what is happening to the dielectric slab? Simple thing, summary, it will undergo polarization. What is the meaning of polarization? Stretching of the atoms or molecules under the influence of an external electric field. So maybe this atom, maybe that is symmetric shape like this. But due to the influence of this electric field, the atoms or molecules get stretched like this. That is what is drawn here. It is very clear, near to the positive charge, the negative charge will be there. See, negative, positive, polarization. So like that, each atom gets undergoes this polarization inside the dielectric slab. That is what is happening. Now, because of this polarization, what is happening to the slab? That is what we are going to study. In this diagram, you see, there is positive charge on the plate, and you can see equal number of negative charge on the other plate. And you just see the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 positive charge I marked here, and here also 10 negative charge. Now, very purposefully, I have drawn the diagram like this. Here you count the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 layer of molecules I marked here. Okay. Now, what is happening inside the slab? This positive charge that is neutralized by this negative charge, and this plus that is neutralized by this minus. The same thing is happening everywhere. So inside the dielectric slab, there is neutralization of positive charge and negative charge. Now what about this negative charge that is not neutralized? So on the left side surface, there is a net negative charge. Similarly, on the right side surface, you can see there is a small net positive charge. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 positive charges are there. So inside this dotted boundary, you see this diagram very carefully. Inside the dotted boundary, how much charge is there? Inside the dotted boundary, how much charge? There is zero charge because plus minus cancellation is there. So inside this dotted boundary, there is no charge. And on the right surface, you can see net positive charge, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And on the left side of the dielectric slab, you can see negative charge. Always from positive charge to negative charge, there is an electric field. So from this plus charge to negative charge, an opposite electric field develops due to polarization. And this electric field is called electric field due to polarization. EP. P stands for polarization. So electric field due to polarization and applied electric field. What about their directions? Very clear. Their directions are opposite. Number one. What about their magnitude? Magnitude of the electric field. Is it same? No. They are not same. This electric field due to polarization is a very weak electric field. Because in the diagram also it is very clear. You can see a large number of plus charge and minus charge here. But electric field due to polarization, that is only 5 positive and 5 negative. Because this material is dielectric or insulator. So less number of free electrons. So that is why the electric field due to polarization is a small electric field acting in the opposite direction. So what is a net electric field inside the conductor, inside the dielectric slab? That is equal to, is it zero? No. Why it is not zero? For example, if this is 100 units and this electric field due to polarization is only 5 units. In the previous case, if it is a conductor, this is also 100. Because the phenomena was induction. Induction plus 100 minus 100. Therefore, net electric field is zero. But in electric field due to polarization, the electric field developed due to polarization is a very small field. So you can see in this example, 100 units towards right side and 5 units towards left side. Therefore, what is the net electric field? Net electric field will be 100 minus 5, 95. Or the net electric field is E naught minus EP. Applied electric field minus electric field due to polarization. That is the net electric field. What is its direction? Is it towards right side or towards left side? Because if two vectors are opposite, the bigger one will decide the direction. So definitely, the direction of this field is towards right side. And the value is less. That is why it is called reduced electric field, ER. So, the summary is this one. You are applying electric field, E0. That E0 is existing towards the right side. And there is a small electric field due to polarization that is existing towards left side. Therefore, the net electric field, ER, is equal to E0 minus EP. And that is acting towards right side. This is what is happening in the case of a dielectric slab. So inside the dielectric slab, there is reduced electric field due to polarization. And this reduced electric field that is connected with your dielectric constant, because the material is a dielectric slab. So your dielectric constant K is equal to dielectric constant. Another name, relative permittivity. Epsilon by epsilon naught. That is what you studied in the previous chapter. And this is equal to E naught by ER. What is E naught? E naught is the applied electric field sigma by epsilon naught. And ER stands for reduced electric field. That is E naught minus EP. Is it greater than 1 or less than 1? Can you tell which is bigger? Numerator or denominator? Which is bigger? It is very clear. Reduced. So definitely your denominator is smaller. Therefore, this ratio is always greater than 1. So dielectric constant is always greater than 1. You know, K is equal to 1 for which material? That is for air. And K is equal to infinity for which material? That is for metals. And for all other materials, dielectric materials, their dielectric constant is more than 1. And already you studied some more relationship for K. One is C for the medium, capacitance of the medium divided by capacitance in air. Also in the first class you studied Coulomb's law, force in air divided by force in the medium. That is also called, all these are relations or definitions of dielectric constants. So summarize this one. Your dielectric constant is E0 by ER, C in the medium by C in the air, or force in air divided by force in the medium. That is called dielectric constant, which is always greater than 1.